Bienvenidos and welcome to the Peabody Museum Collections. We are here surveying the national birds of Latin American countries. I am holding here golden eagle. This is a specimen from the United States, but this species is also found in northern Mexico, in Baja California and northern states, and it's declining. Therefore, it's on the list of threatened species in Mexico. You can actually see that unlike bald eagle, the golden eagle and members of this genus have feathered tarsi, the lower part of the leg, just up to the toes. So this feathering is unique. And I have here another raptor. This one is a national bird for Panama. So I'm going to try to gently lift it. This is a harpy eagle, and it's a juvenile bird. Adult would have a big black band on the breast. And if we can maybe focus quickly on the talons of this bird, this is really the largest and most powerful eagle in the Americas and the world. And these talons here, the claws, are the size of grizzly bear's claws. This bird is pretty widely distributed. In Panama, it's mostly found in the Darién region in the eastern Panama, against the border of Colombia, because it requires large swaths of mature forest. One pair can occupy a territory of 25 kilometers squared. So these kind of forests are harder and harder for these birds to find, and they have declined and even disappeared from parts of their range. But in Panama, it's still a reliable bird to see. Then I wanted to show you the spectacular resplendent quetzal. Here's a male from Honduras, but this bird is a national bird of Guatemala. And what you see here as what looks like a tail is in fact upper tail coverts. So these are feathers that come over the tail, and the tail is this black and white, much shorter set of feathers. So this very long tail, let's call it, is in the birds from north of the range. But if you go to countries like Costa Rica or Panama, where this species reaches with its range, you see that the tails are much shorter in this population. One other thing I wanted to point out that on this male here, the red of its belly is rather faded. And this is actually what happens when the bird is on the exhibit for a long time. This bird is mounted for display in for galleries and has glass eyes and clearly was exposed to light quite a bit. So this is a challenge we face when we exhibit specimens in the galleries. But here is a fresh specimen, a female, and you can actually see how much brighter red her belly is. But you can also notice that structural colors, those that don't depend on pigments, don't fade, and in this case it's bright green, beautiful preserved color. Then here is a toucan. This is actually Sulfuratus, the kill-billed toucan in English. And in the country of Belize, this is a national bird, and they sometimes call this just bill bird. And that's obviously because of this massive bill, which in life would be brightly rainbow-colored with green, red, orange. Unfortunately, in specimens in a collection, these colors are gone. So we usually, when we collect these, record the colors with photography or just a description in the field. And here we have a specimen of a turquoise-browed motmot. This bird was chosen as a national bird by two countries, by El Salvador, I believe, where it's called torogos, and in Nicaragua, where it's called guardabarranco. In both cases, these names make a lot of sense. In one case, torogos is from it's an onomatopoeic name, and it resembles the triple call that birds make in some situations, like alarming, when they alarm. And the other name, guardabarranco, simply refers, it translates into guard of the barranca or the valley. They nest in cliffs, excavate burrows in banks of earth, and sometimes can nest colonially. And one other interesting feature here, you see that the tail has a part of the of the vein missing. This is actually a natural phenomenon. The tail ends with these beautiful iridescent blue spatulas, and these are the only two central feathers that do this trick. These naturally fall off. The bird doesn't have to pluck this, but the feather starts with a complete vein, so that's kind of an interesting phenomenon only found in motmots. And yeah, this is a bird that normally would be hard to find in the forest. Many species of motmots can be easily heard but not easily seen because they sit motionless and they are sit and wait predators somewhere in the forest understory. But this particular trogon, motmot, is actually quite common and can be found in more open habitats. I saw my first bird in the Yucatan of Mexico and it was sitting on a wire of the power line. So it can be found even in urban, suburban areas. Then we have this spectacular macaw. This bird is a national bird of Honduras. Scarlet macaw has a wide range. It's found not only in Central America, but also in South America, but has declined. And pet trade and habitat loss is are some of the reasons. They require large cavities for nesting, and what usually you see bears in flying in pairs or small family groups. And luckily, it's still relatively easy to find in most of the countries. But in Honduras, where it's a national bird, it's now restricted to Mosquitia region. And finally, a rather drab bird. This is a national bird of Costa Rica. And it has a rather interesting name, yiguirro. It's what I call the nightingale phenomenon, where a drab-looking bird, like in Europe, the nightingales, has a spectacular song, and it's really valued for the song. But also, it often sings at night, so it's often at the time when people are on a date, and it's kind of a romantic scene, nice song, nice conditions, and farmers rely on the fact that the bird starts singing very intensively at the beginning of rains, when rainy season begins, so it's a good time to start planting.